السلام عليكم. Let me go briefly to what we did last time. Last time we said we can, if we have a single loop, single node per circuit, like here we have a single loop circuit, okay? Everything on the circuit is connected in series, so they have the same current, okay, I. And how to solve it, for instance, to find the current. And if you find the current, you can find anything on the circuit. Okay, for instance, the voltage on the resistors. Okay, so the idea is to assume a direction of the current, like the one over here, clockwise direction, okay, or counterclockwise. And then you form the ratio, the current is the volt, sum of the voltages over sum of the resistor. Why the sum of the resistor? We said that the sum of the resistor, because they are all in series, and resistor in series add, as we will see later, okay? And the sum of the voltage, you have to take care of the sign. So you sum them algebraically. How do you sum them algebraically? We said, if the current passing the voltage source from the negative, يعني entering the negative, leaving the positive, you do not change the sign. You just take the value of that voltage source, whether positive or negative. And if it is entering from the positive, leaving the negative, no, then you put a negative sign in front of the value. Okay, so, and this, if you want to remember it, basically is the opposite of the passive sign convention we already mentioned regarding the power or Ohm's law. Remember, in power and Ohm's law, if the current is entering from the positive, you don't change the sign. If the current entering, I mean, if the current entering from the positive, the power absorbed is VI. If the current entering from the negative, it's minus VI. Same thing for the voltage on the resistor. طبعا, we saw this example, but also we said we can get this one, this formula by applying KVL on the loop. You apply KVL on the loop over here and making, طبعا here you will go counterclockwise, and making a voltage drop on the resistor when the current entering the resistor, like this one over here, we make it a voltage drop. Why we make it a voltage drop? Because we don't want a negative sign to be on the voltage. Same thing over here. This is positive, negative, we put it, is equal 5i, okay? Somebody will say, but you already, on the question he is asking about V2, and the polarity in V2 is the positive up. I said this at the end. First, I'm calculating I can assume this is positive, negative, and I can assume it negative, positive if I want. But if you assume it negative, positive, I have to put minus 5i. It's just a way to avoid writing the negative sign. That's all. If you do it using KVL, you will get exactly the same ratio and the same number, okay? طبعا, this is the other example we did. And we came to the single node pair. In the single node pair, it's exactly the same or similar. But here, what is common is the voltage is the common across all the element in parallel. Okay, so you assume the polarity, either positive up, negative down, or negative up, positive down. It's up to you, okay? And if you find, طبعا, the voltage, this is the common, you can find anything, any current on the circuit, okay? Across R1, across R2, you just will be V over R1, V over R2, and etc. Okay? So here you assume a voltage with a polarity, and then you find that voltage by taking the ratio of the current over the summation of the conductance. Why the summation of the conductance? We said the summation of the conductance because we're having a resistors. And if I take the conductance of the resistor, yani 1 over R1, for instance, this is the conductance, 1 over R2, 1 over R3, then the conductance in parallel add. a conductance in parallel add. Remember the this is it's the duality or the opposite of the resistor. The resistor in series add, but in parallel it's 1/R equivalent. But here, no, it is the conductance that add in parallel, but in series it is 1/G equivalent. Anyhow, the voltage is the ratio of the summation of the current. The same thing algebraically over the summation of the conductance. And the summation is exactly the same thing. We look at the current with respect to the voltage. Like over here, the current is entering from the negative. If it's entering from the negative, we do not change the sign, like over here. But if it enters from the positive, يعني if it was like this, V, in this case, we put a negative sign in front of the value of the current, okay? We looked at this example over here. Here, for instance, we need I1 and I2, okay? This is I1 and I2, okay? And here we form the ratio. The numerator, the denominator is the summation of the conductance. This is 1/4, 1/3 plus 1, the conductance of these three parallel resistors. This here, we look at the V. This is the V we are assuming. Positive up, negative down. And we look at the 2, هنا, هذا. Now, the current 2 is entering from where? It's entering from the positive. So, معناها إيش? معناها I put a negative sign in front of the value, which is 2. And here it is. Minus in front of the 2. يعني لو كان الـ current اللي هنا minus 2, I will put here minus 2. Okay? طبعاً you can say if this is minus 2 down, it will be plus 2 up. معناها الكارت entering from the negative, so it is plus 2, okay? You can do it when, you know, you can manipulate the term if you want. طيب, نجي لل 5. ال 5 is the same thing. The current is entering from the negative, so we don't put anything as it is. يعني it is plus the value, like the one over here. Similarly, for the 4, it's entering from the positive, so we have to put a negative sign over here. We find V, then we go and find the I1 and I2, but just taking the ratio. هنا I1 مثلا, take I1. And I assume V as a positive up, negative down, and I1 is going down, entering from the positive. So I1 is equal V over R. Why? Because the current entering from the positive. Now V is negative, we found, and 4, so I will get minus 1.58. We come to I2 هنا, the current I2 is leaving the positive, يعني it's entering from the negative. So it is minus V over R. Now V is negative, which is this one over here, and this negative over here because it's entering from the negative. So at the end, I get 0.211, okay? Now, this course, as we said, we are not going to discuss dependent source. We will always discuss independent sources. Independent sources, a sign حقتهم اللي هي this, a circle, okay, whether voltage or current. A dependent source is not part of our curriculum. So when you find it, you just ignore it in the book, okay? Let's look at this example. Suppose I connect, we're going to see if the connection is valid or not valid. I connect a 10 volt like with 10 volt like this. Is it valid? Yes, valid. Why? Because these are two parallel and they have identical polarity, identical value. So this is valid. What about this one? This is also valid. Why? Because they are connected in series. And since they are connected in series, two current like this, the current is the same, and a 5 and a 5. So this is also valid. What about this one? This is not valid. Why? Because I'm connecting two voltage source and they are different in value. So this is not valid. okay connection or not permissible. What about if I have this one, 5 ampere? Also, this is not valid. Why? Because this is 2 series, but here is 5, and here is 2, and this is not valid. Current interim does not equal current output. And here also, if you put KVL around this, you will find +5 -5 = 0, which is not valid. What about this one? If you have 2 sources, different, يعني current source and voltage source, then they are valid regardless how they are connected. Why? Because the voltage source, it says A is greater than B, A is greater than B by 10, regardless the current that is going through it. هذا definition حق voltage source. Okay, let the current be 5 ampere. That's fine. It doesn't affect. There is no relation between the current that is going through the voltage source and the voltage source. The same thing for the current. So that mean you can connect them to any way, you know, parallel or series. They don't have, they have no relation in value or in the direction of the current. Okay. Now we now come to combining resistor, and this you already know. Okay. So resistor and series, as you know, you just add them together. Current is the same, voltage are different, so you add them. So VS, طبعاً this is how you prove it. You take KVL around this loop with the voltage drop in each one of these elements, plus minus. You form the KVL, you solve, and you will find that R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. So basically, you can remove a 7 resistor over here, the blue, and replace it with a single resistor, okay? Because they are in series. So whether they have 7 element or you have K element, it's exactly the same. Let's look at this one over here. Now I'm going to call volunteers. So Abbas, Fadl, Musa. Abbas?
Yes, here.
What is the equivalent? Abbas, فقط Abbas. Abbas, what is the equivalent resistors between A and B?
16,
correct. Because you add them, they are in series, okay?
Yes.
Now let's see. Khalid Muhammad Zahrani. Khalid Muhammad Zahrani.
Yes, doctor, yes.
What's the equivalent?
We add them because they are in series. So
what is it?
It is 21.
Exactly. Okay. Resistor in parallel. What you do, طبعاً you know the formula. If you have parallel, 1 over R equivalent equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3, Rn. Okay. The conductance will add. Why? Because أصلاً if you look over here, 1 over R equivalent, هو G equivalent. 1 over R1, هو G1, and so on. This is why they add. Okay? Voltage is the same, because they are parallel, but current are different. And this is the proof. هناك we found a combination using, or combining using KVL. And we can find using KCL exactly the same procedure. And what you get is you get R equivalent, or 1 over R equivalent is equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3 plus 1 over R4 plus whatever number of parallel element. Here I'm going to show you something. Do not let vision or what look like parallel, you define it as a parallel. Do not make the mistake, these R1 and R2, they are two vertical up like this, they are parallel. No, here is the big mistake. Go, as I advised you before, go to what? To the definition. R1 and R3, for instance, it is true. What's the definition? They have to be sharing two nodes, the upper or lower, or left or right. It depends on how they are connected. Here, for instance, to be parallel, they have to show to share the upper and lower. The lower they share, they are the same. It's correct. But the upper one, no, it's not the same. Why? The node اللي هنا, this one, is not the same as this one. Why? Because we have a resistor over here. That's why. Okay? So this I want to point out for you in order for you to rely on what? To rely on the definition. Don't rely what look like parallel, what look like series. Okay? No, go to the definition. Not unless it is very obvious, then something else. Okay? طبعا هنا if we equivalent قلنا for the parallel is 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2, etc. So in general, 1 over R equivalent for K parallel is 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3, etc. to 1 over RK. Okay? And the conductance, they will add. Okay? Why? Because G equivalent is just here, 1 over R equivalent. Okay? 1 over R equivalent. Okay. Determine the equivalent R at AB. We just apply the definition. 1 over R equivalent equal 1 over 3 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over... How the result is in Siemens. Why? Because what you are adding here is the conductance. 1 over R equivalent is not a resistor, it's a conductance. So to find the resistor, you take the reciprocal for this one, which is 0.779 ohm. Okay? 0.779 ohm. Okay. Two resistors in parallel. How do you combine two resistors in parallel? Well, you combine them like you combine resistors. So it will be, for instance, 1 over R equivalent, here, 1 over R equivalent equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. Then I take a common denominator, which is R1, the R2, and here I put R2 plus R1. Now R equivalent is the reciprocal for this one, which is this. So basically this formula, you should memorize it, really. It's very helpful. Why? Because it's very quick. It's just the multiplication over the addition. And this you can do it very quickly in the calculator. Okay? Rather than you do 1 over R equivalent equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. And I add them. Then I take a reciprocal. Hadi one shot. You can do it. Okay? Now, what happened if the two resistors are equal? Hena R. Or hena R. And here is R. What you will have, a multiplication, because you are multiplying R1 for R2, يعطيك what? R square. Well, addition, R1 plus R2, يعطيك 2R. So this one is going to equal to R over 2. Ha, this way, you can combine two equal resistors if they are in parallel, and it's quickly, it's just half of the resistor. Like the opposite, if they are in series, R and R, it will be double the resistor. So if they are in series, it's double the resistor. If they are in parallel, it's half the resistor. Okay? If you don't want to memorize this formula, but you have to stick with this one then. One, a general case. Okay? It's up to you. Okay? فإذا معناها, if it is two equal, it's half. Like 1,000 and 1,000, يطلع 500. Okay? If there is two resistor, one is large, very large, and one very small, the equivalent is closer to the small. The result will be, okay? Now, we can use the two resistor to find the equivalent of a three resistor, rather than I use 1 over R equivalent. 1 over R equivalent. Equal. 1 over half plus 1 over 8 plus 1 over 8. I can do it quickly. How? I can combine the 8 and 8 because this is, I can know it quickly that it's equal to 4. Remember, 2 equal in parallel is half. And now these two now becoming 4, I can use the product over the summation. 2 multiplying 4 is 8. 8 and the summation is 6. So it will be 4 over 3. Okay, 4 over 3. Okay, or you use if you want this one, but as I told you, this will take more time for you. Okay, more time. Circuit solution by circuit reduction. Sometimes you want to combine the resistors or combine the voltage sources. For instance, if you have series voltage sources, if you have parallel current source, you combine them to reduce a circuit. Let me give you an example. Suppose you have a circuit like this. And here, and suppose I want the current antenna, I. This. What I can do, I know these two are in parallel. I can combine them. يعطيني مثلا R equivalent 1. With 3 هنا in parallel, يعطيني R equivalent 2 مثلا. Here it is. هذا R equivalent 1 and 2. And now after I combine them, and like here, these two, طلع two resistor هنا equivalent, they become what? They become series. I can combine them also. So the combination, it will be parallel مع R7 over here. Now I can combine the R7 مع هذا, يعطيني a resistor هنا. طبعا in all of this, this is I. It doesn't change because you are replacing a 3 resistor with 2 resistor by equivalent. For other will not affect the current. At the end, I will end up with 1 resistor. And suppose this is plus minus V. Then in this case, I at the end will equal V over R prime S or something. This one over here. Okay. This one over here. Okay. That's the idea behind circuit reduction. Okay. Let's look at this example. Suppose in this example, what I want to do is the following. I want to find V and هذا. I want to find VX. I want to find I. And I want to find IX. Well, which one you find, which one is first, it doesn't matter. أهم شيء إنك find them all. Okay? So what do? I start if I want to, طبعا we will learn later that you can use many other methods. But if we want circuit reduction, what do? I realize that these two are in parallel. These two resistor. Two parallel with two. Okay, two parallel with two. عبد الرحمن مفرح عبد الرحمن مفرح عسيري عبد الرحمن عسيري عبد الرحمن عسيري أحمد عمر
اي نعم دكتور
احمد عمر go ahead
yes.
You combine 2 and 2 what that will be in parallel are you with us
yes
بدر عبد الله بدر الشهري
نعم يا دكتور
what is it
1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 this are equivalent
اي بس احنا قلنا احنا if they are parallel you are right 1 over 2 yes. over 1 over 2 هذا ال r equivalent it's not r equivalent this it's is 1 over r equivalent
دكتور بس
قلنا yeah if they are 2 equal what that will be The equivalent resistor. Hassan Abdullah Al-Hijji. Hassan Al-Hijji.
Yes, sir.
What is it?
will be one.
Will be one. Okay. Please pay attention. ترى احنا بداية من الأسبوع الجاي we are going to have special event. I don't know how I'm going, but there will be some sort of a short, very short quiz, and it will combine with the attendance. So make sure that you pay attention. Okay. So here the two and the two are in parallel. You combine them and becoming one ohm because they are in parallel. Okay. One. Now this one becoming now is in series. This one is becoming in series. This one is becoming in series. Okay. This one becoming in series. So it is two. Over here. One and plus one is two. Now this two is in parallel. These two are in parallel. So it give me what? It give me one. So that mean I can say that this one is equal. This is 5 ampere. And this is now 1 ampere. Now, طبعاً V is the same, هنا, plus minus V, because when you combine in parallel, the, لاحظ هنا شوف, when you combine in parallel, the voltage is the same, ما يتغير. When you combine in series, the current is the same, ما يتغير. هنا إذا معناها V is going to equal to what? What V will be equal to?
Doctor, it will be 1 yes. ohm, not 1 ampere.
Sorry?
That's right.
Thank you. Thank you. You're absolutely right. يعني الصراحة ما أبغى أقول لكم إني أنا عملت on purpose, no, not on purpose. But here this one. This is ohms. You're absolutely right. Thank you. Now, what will be the voltage in here? It will be 5 volt. So V is going to equal 5 volt. And like it's done over here. Hina done it. He took the current and divided it by the combined conductance because the combined conductance, they are in parallel, صح? Hina the conductance will resistor are the same, equivalent. Hina, لأن one reciprocal حقه is one. Okay, so he took 5/1, which is 5 volt over here. You find V now, the 5 volt. Okay. If you find V to be 5 volt, then you will be able now to find IX, which is the 5 volt over the 2 ohm, okay? 5 volt over the 2 ohm, which is 5/2. Now, so we found V awwal, we found IX. Now you find I come here back to the going back. Let me remove the arrows. Okay, now you found IX, you will be able to find VX. VX is going to equal just equal 1, VIX, which is 1, which is equal to 1. Okay? Not 1, sorry. IX is not 1. I am sorry. IX is equal 5/2. IX is equal 5/2. So it's equal 5/2. You found now, you find VX 5/2. You go back again and you find I, Hana, which is equal VX 2 because the resistor across it is 2 and it gives you 5/2. Is this clear? Any question? Okay.
Yeah, Dixon.
Yes.
The resistor and the VX, I think it's 2 ohm, not 1 ohm.
Again, what is it? The
resistor, in the VX, yeah, the resistor. I think it's 2 ohm, not 1 ohm.
You are right. You are قصدك أنت هذه, this one, صح. But this
لا, is الثاني اللي على اليسار.
اللي على اليسار هذه 2 also.
إيه, بس القانون.
Okay, القانون when two are parallel, it's becoming one هنا, صح؟
Yes, yes, okay.
And VX is the same. It doesn't change.
Okay.
VX is the same. So basically, IX is going, هنا IX is going like this to the equivalent, which is 1 ohm. Okay, IX and VX is across them. Now, any other question? Any other question? Okay. We come now to another topic is called the voltage and current division. What we mean about voltage division? Let's start with it. It says in some application, we need to develop more than one voltage level. Example, مثلا انت عندك a power supply. The value of this power supply, let's say 120 volt. Whatever that power supply. And you have your equipment, let's say it's a lamp. Light. الريتنج حقها it only accept مثلا plus or minus across it مثلا 30 volt. طيب how can I get الان اللي انا عندي 120 لو احط ال 120 على الاكوبمنت كامل it will burn it as you know. So what you do is you take part of this 120, you divide ال 120 to several level or two level depending on how many applications you have. فمثلا suppose this is the 120 volt and this is my I take my lamp is over here. Now I make sure that this V2 is 30 volt. Why? Because 120 will divide across the R1, and it will divide across the R2. The summation of V1 and V2 is 120. طبعاً if you make V2 30, طبعاً V1 will be 90. To make the summation for them is 120. لكن how do you make this division? This is the idea that we will be discussing now. How you can make, how can I put the value R1 and R2 such that I get 30 volt هنا. Okay, that's what we will do next. Okay, that's what we will do next. We can come over here. We do the analysis of the circuit. We said we having two resistors. They are in series, R1 and R2. معناها it have a common current. A common current, I, like this. If this is the case, then I start by finding this current, current I. طبعا VS is known, R1 is known, R2 is known. What you can do KVL. You say, for instance, you come over here. هذا voltage rise. And هذا ال voltage drop على ال R1. قلنا احنا إذا حطيت ال positive up. والnegative down. هذا يصير R1. I. This one become plus minus R2. I. Now if you do a voltage drop هنا, voltage drop, it become minus VS plus R1 I plus R2 I, okay, equal to a zero. You solve and you get this VS, اللي هو هنا, VS, you solve. And you get this VS is equal IR1 plus IR2. And from that, I can solve for I, and I is going to equal VS over R1 plus R2. But let me tell you something. After this, and after the previous lecture, or this lecture today, and the previous lecture is single loop, since I have a single loop here and a common current, the equivalent حق الريزستر is going to be what? يعني هذا السيركت, I can do it like this. I can make it like this. This is VS. And this is the equivalent resistor, which is R1 plus R2. طبعا, if I have three resistors in series, it will be R1 plus R2 plus R3, etc. And that's your I. Anna. Now you tell me, طبعا, the voltage across it from here to here is also VS. So right away, I can say that I is equal VS over R1 without doing KVL, without right away. From the circuit over here, like this, I say that there is a single voltage. طبعا, you have to know the direction of the current with respect to the polarity also, okay? Since I have a single source, I can visualize it like this and write the expression quickly, I equal VS over R1. طيب, we continue. الآن, we go and find what is R V1 and V2 using Ohm laws. Now, V1 is equal IR1, okay? Current is entering from the positive, leaving the negative, okay? And I already found over here. So I substitute and I get VS over R1 plus R2, okay? يعني, let's compare it with V2. V2 IR2 and equal VS R2 على R1 plus R2. Well, let me put the two expression beside each other. الآن I can look at these two expression. هذا V1 وهذا V2. Remember, VS هذا expression, شوف هذا. هذا basically is the I, as a matter of fact. هذا اللي هو I. Basically what you are saying, you're saying V1 equal R1 I, V2 equal. But you put it like this one. طيب. Now, let me compare these two expressions. Let me compare these two expressions. Okay, we do this. The denominator is the same for both of them, R1 plus R2, which is basically an equivalent resistor of a series. And also, the multiplication here is the same. هذا multiplying VS وهذا multiplying VS. What is different? إنه V1 controlled by R1 والV2 controlled by R2. Let's look at basically three elements. يمكن يكون عندنا الأكثر حتى نعرفه. If I apply it to three resistor, for instance, طبعا I is going to equal to without if you want without doing KVL, على طول we say VS over a summation حق الريزستر, like this. طبعا لأن the current coming from the positive هنا, okay? So it's a positive هنا. So this is why it's VS over R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now I can write V1 as R1 I1, R1 I, which is this expression over here, and V2 R2 I, and V3 Okay, now, if I compare the three expression, what do I see? I see that the denominator, and which is in blue, and the multiplication on this VS are the same. Basically, what is the difference is for V1, you control it by a ratio, how this is R1 over the total resistor, مضروبة في VS, and R2 by R2, and V3 by R3. In general, then, I can say, for instance, لو عندي more element, I will say, مثلا, V, خلنا نقول, 7. It will equal to, right away, R7, okay, over the equivalent resistors. The equivalent resistor in series, we could have 10, 20, 100, the equivalent resistor, RI, مضروبة في VS. That's basically it. إنه what could, إنه ال V7 اللي هو 7 element, you put here the denominator and the numerator is R7, like this, okay? Like this. So this one, we remove هنا. So we will have, in general, if I have VI, if I have VI, it will be R1 over R1 plus R2 plus Rn VS, okay? Where VI will controlled by RI, okay? Now, let's look at this example. Suppose I want to find the voltage V over here, okay? Using voltage division. And you can find V by finding the current, if you want the current, over here or multiply the current in the on the resistor, but we want to use the voltage division. Okay, let's see Hannah. Abdullah Hani.
Yes.
Okay, so how do you find the V Hannah using voltage division? Let me remind you, just one second. To find the voltage, مثلا على ال1, a numerator be having R1, a resistor associated with the V1, مثلا هنا, with denominator having a summation حق الريزستر, أو ال R equivalent, مضروبة في الفولتج. Okay?
Okay.
Like this. Okay. Now apply it هنا. What that will be?
It will be 5.
لا. It will be a numerator will be 2.
No, I mean 5 the voltage.
Yeah, هنا ال 5.
Yes.
صح. وهذا
2 over 5.
Oh, 2 over 5. Correct? And that will equal to 2, صح? Correct?
Yes. For R2.
الآن, what you did, 50% correct. But what you forgot that the polarity هنا, it's the yes. opposite of the polarity هنا. لو البولاريتي هنا positive, negative, what you did correct. But this is then, it's a tricky. This is why I don't want you to have, you know, you jump right away. Make sure that you satisfy the law and satisfy direction of a current polarity. In this case, you have to put a minus sign هنا. Okay? So it will be minus 2. Clear? Okay. واضحة؟
Yes, clear.
Okay. So basically, it will be 2 or minus 2 over minus 2 plus 2 plus 3 في 5, okay? في 5. Okay. طيب. I think I will stop here because that's what we reach with the previous lecture. And I as I told you, I need to synchronize, but just hold a minute, hold a second. I'll have to stop the recording, Hannah. We'll stop.